Hello friends, welcome to CNC Programming Club. In today's session, we will be discussing about face milling manual operation in NX manufacturing. For this exercise, we will use this component and we will remove the material from the top surface using manual toolpath. So let's start manufacturing. Go to application and select manufacturing. Then select CAM General and mill planner as the option and click OK. Now first step is to create tool. So click on create tool. For this exercise, let me create a tool manually. So just select the anvil option and click OK. Here I just wanted to have 30 mm diameter tool. So I will not change that diameter, as well as I will not change the length and flute length. Number of flute is very less. So let me just increase it from 2 to 4 and click OK. If you want to display the tool, just select the mill and the tool will be displayed. Now let's start with the step number 2 and click on geometric view. Click on this plus button, double click the workpiece, and the first option is to specify part. So select this option and select the component, click OK. So our part has been specified, that you can see from this display option. Now let's specify the blank. Click on this option. For this exercise, part outline is the best option for this. Now let me just add some material in Z direction. So I just entering 2 mm in ZM plus axis, and here you can see some material is already been there. Now if I just wanted to add the dimension in the X, then I suppose to add it here. As I enter 5, you will see that on X and Y, both the direction the material is being specified. Click OK to confirm it. Now let me just display the part which is here, and here is the blank. So if you can see, the XM, YN and ZM lies on the top of this surface of the workpiece. So we should be shifting this MCS from this top of the workpiece to the top of the blank, and the thickness of this part is 2 mm. So click OK. For that we just have to go to MCS mill. We just double click on MCS mill, and we have to enter the Z coordinate as 2, and you will see that the part is being shifting up. And let's just see it. As you can see that previously it was here, now it has been 2 mm up from that plane. So our MCS has been set. So step 2 is over. Now let's go to step number 3, which is create operation. So click on create operation. This time we will be using face milling manually. In previous session we have discussed about face milling using boundaries. In face milling with boundary, we just have to select the area to be cut, and we just have to select the cutting pattern. From this, the toolpath will be generated automatically. But in case of the face milling manual, we have to generate toolpath manual. So that is a slight difference between face milling with boundary and face milling manual. So let me just click on face milling manual, and in program select NC program as the option. In select, select the tool that we have made. In geometry it would be workpiece, and in method it would be mill finish, and click OK to confirm it. Now in this we have to specify cut area at first. So click on this option and select the top surface of the workpiece and click OK. Now since we have defined the blank distance as 2 mm, let me just correct that as 2 mm. Here I will not entering any depth of cut, which means that all the material will be removed in single cut. If I just specify the depth per cut, then the material will be cut in numbers of cutting levels. So I will skipping that depth of cut, and I will not be selecting any final floor stock. Now let's define feeds and speed. So click on this option and select 250 as the surface speed, and let me enter 0.11 as the feed per tooth, and click on this calculator button. Your spindle speed as well as your feed rate both will be calculated. To confirm, click OK. Then click on generate toolpath. Here the dotted line boundaries will be generated automatically, and the gap between the outer face to the boundary is the tool radius. For our case, the diameter of the tool is 30 mm, which means that the gap between this line is 15 mm. Click on this option and click on this. You will see some of the options that you already have it in face milling with boundaries. So we will not be selecting any of such options, but we will be selecting manual option and click on edit. Now once this screen has been displayed, it is having so many options in this. So out of this, first three options stands for the non-cutting movements, which means that a tool can move from one point to the other point without any interaction with the workpiece. And from fourth option to the last option, all the options were for the cutting operations for the different geometrical shape. And we have to select suitable options out of this. Now let me start with the second option, which is reposition to the shape. So I have selected that option, and let me just select this point, which means that the tool will be entered at this location. After that, I have to select move to point in order to reach a tool from that point to this point. Now after that, we have an arc. So if I just select this option, the tool will move like this. So instead of that, I just have to select this option, tangent arc. And I have to select the end point of the arc. Now you can see that the tool is moving in a curved path. Now after that, I just go back to the move to point and select the point. So the tool will move from that point to this point. Now after that, again we have arc, so I will be selecting again tangent arc and selecting this option, and again go back to the move to shape. This time I have to select move to shape so that the tool will moving out of the workpiece. If I select move to point, then the tool will just stop at the edge of the workpiece. So move to shape is the better choice in this case, and click OK. So as you can see that the tool path has been set. Now from this point, I just have to lift up the tool and reorient the tool to some other location. So in order to do this, let me just add into that. So click on this insert button to continuing this operation. So click on insert. And now I have to lift up the tool first. So I will just reposition to the shape and select this point first. So tool will lift up from this point to up. Then let me just enter tool at this location. Then I have to select move to point, and let me select the end point of the line. Then again curve is there, so I will be selecting tangent arc. Then I have to go back and select move to point and select this point. Then select tangent arc, select the end point of the arc, and this time if I just select move to point, let me just show it. If I just select the move to point, the tool will end at that location. So if I just wanted to change it, what should I do? I just select the reject last action. So the last action has already been rejected. Now instead of this move to point, if I just select move to shape, then the tool will move outward side, as you can see. Now after that, I have to lift up the tool, so I will reposition to the shape and I will be selecting the same point, and the tool has been lifted up, and click OK to confirm it. Now let me just display this part. So as you can see that the tool will start entering from this point. It will machine up like this. It will lift up at this. It will reorient the tool at this location. And it will again start cutting. And it has been moving in this manner. So let's click OK first and then verify the tool path. Lower down the speed and just play. So as you can see that from the top surface all the material is clearly been removed. Now suppose that if you wanted to remove this material on the side wall, so how to do that? So we just have to go back to face milling manual, double click that and click on generate toolpath, select this plus button and find out the last option. You just have to click on this insert, reposition to a point, and let me just select any of the point like this. I'm just selected that point, and after that you just have to select move along shape. So if you do that, your tool will be moving like this. The tool is been moving like that path and it will end. Just click here so that the tool can end at that location and click OK. Now there is one issue with that. If you just press the home button, you will see that the tool path generated for the peripheral cut is on the same level. This both is on the same level. So we just have to lower down its depth. So for that, just select this and double click it, and just in the level offset just write -10 and that and click OK. Now once you do that, as you can see that the toolpath has been lowered down now, and click OK. And now let's run the simulation. So as you can see that all the material has been properly removed from all the top surface as well as this adjacent sides. Here the material will be there, which is nothing but radius of the tool. So that will not be able to remove, but if we use the smaller diameter tool, the lesser the material will be here. So that's it related to face milling manual. This process is not being mostly used because we are not defining toolpath manual. So as and when needed, just use it only. Otherwise, opt for face milling with boundaries. If you are facing any doubts or if you are having any queries related to this, just post that on comment section. Thank you so much.